listeners, and I'm sure
Yes.
there's going to be lots of questions for you. So let's dive straight into the heart of the matter.
Sure.
How important do you feel both the logical and legal reasoning sections are?
Let me start by saying I think all sections are equally important because a lot of the sections are, you know, something like, for example, maths. I know that's not part of the main presentation that I have to make, but what I'm saying is that, for instance, it's an area which a lot of people tend to start ignoring. So I don't want to start by saying legal is extremely important or logic is extremely important and thereby imply that you can take a little more liberties with a section like math. So I think all sections are extremely important because every mark is important. Now that the paper is, for those of you who are a little uninitiated on the matter, the CLAT pattern has been structurally changed to a very large extent. So now it's not 200 questions as it earlier was when you gave the paper or some ancient time when I gave the paper.
Right.
But it's 150 marks, which means the value of each mark is obviously proportionally gone up higher. And the closeness in terms of cutoffs, etc., is going to be so logic, legal, both are extremely important sections. Now, legal in particular is a little more important than other sections for two reasons, I believe. One is it has 25% weightage, so there's a huge chunk of the paper which is still legal reasoning as it was earlier. And B, in case of cutoff, and it's a rare situation, but in case of you know, the same marks that two people score on the CLAT paper, the ultimate tiebreaker is decided on the basis of legal. Now, it might not matter to probably 99% of the people, but ask that to someone who had ranked 57 maybe or 55, now the general category seats in NLS, and on tiebreak got 56 and waiting list one never clear and therefore had to join another college altogether.
Mm-hmm.
For that one person, and you don't want to be that one unfortunate person who missed out on it. So that's why I think legal has a little slightly more important area than others. Now, logical reasoning is uniquely important for a completely different reason. Because logical reasoning has both critical reasoning, which is English based, and analytical reasoning, which is maths based. So while it might seem to a lot of people that logical reasoning is just English oriented, it's actually not. There's quite a bit of maths involved in parts, especially parts of analytical reasoning. So it'll help you kickstart your preparation process. And
are your paper, at least in 2011, the English section and the critical reasoning section were quite
yes.
interchangeable because of the amount of reading heavy.
I remember. I think it's a good benchmark for everyone to understand how sometimes. So I always give people two CLAT paper examples. So 2011 paper would be one of the best examples, I think, of all time to understand that if you're never going to be able to even go through probably about 70% of the paper, which means you're going to get nowhere close to Padmini's 173, which is an insane score, by the way, and congratulations.
Thank you. Decades ago.
But I mean, you get the idea. And then I give everybody the example of the 2015 paper, where if you decided that you can probably take a little load off the math section, then there's absolutely no point giving that paper in 2015 because it was heavily maths focused. I think the logical reasoning section was so brutally dominated by the maths areas that I think 35 out of 40 questions were maths based. And on top of it, that's 20 marks of the maths section anyway.